Once in a while, you need to create a script and run it in the background. There are a few approaches that you can take. Probably the simplest one is to just add end symbol to the end of the command. Also, if you want to close terminal, append nohub before the command. If your script exits for some reason, you would need to restart it manually. The better approach is to use systemd, system and service manager for Linux. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a simple systemd service that can run your script in the background and restart it in case of the failure. First of all, let's create a simple Python HTTP server. We're going to run it on the localhost 8080. It will accept only HTTP GET requests and return hello string back to the client. We can also allow user to exit the program by hitting Ctrl C or delete key on the keyboard. Let's try to run it in foreground first and make sure that it works. Then open a new tab and try to access the server with the curl command. If you get hello message from the server, that means it works. Now we want this HTTP server to run all the time, be restarted in case of a failure, and even survive Linux restarts. That's where systemd comes into play. Let's go ahead and create a systemd service file. It's a bare minimum configuration to get you started. Make sure to specify your Linux user and exec start command to start your server. You can also provide environment variables to your script. The important parameter is restart. You can either set it to always or restart your script only on failure. By default, when you configure restart equal to always, as we did, the systemd gives up restarting your service if it fails to start more than 5 times within the 10 seconds interval. The restart sect directive also has an impact on the outcome. If you set it to restart after 3 seconds, then you can never reach 5 failed retries within 10 seconds. The simplest fix that always works is to set start limit interval sec to 0. This way, the systemd will attempt to restart your service forever. It's a good idea to set restart sec to at least 1 second to avoid putting too much stress on your server when things start going wrong. Now, let's test the system service. Go ahead and start the server. To automatically start your service when Linux boots up, enable the service. Then check the status. In case it fails and you need to find a reason, or you just want to follow the logs, you can use journalctl command. Use curl to test. The last thing that I want to discuss in this video is that you can manage dependencies for your service. For example, if your server needs a database, you may use after Postgres.service directive to instruct systemd to start your Python server only after the Postgres starts. This will only work when the Linux boots up and both services are enabled. If you want, you can add another requires Postgres directive. Even if the Postgres is down and you try to start your Python server, the systemd first starts the Postgres and then your program. Systemd has been the default system and service manager for Linux in Red Hat, CentOS, Fedora, Ubuntu, Debian, and others for several years now, and it should become your go-to tool to run services and your scripts in the background. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.